Hello everyone, I am Prashant S.Malge, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, we will discuss the methods for testing of sequential circuits. Learning outcome. At the end of the session, student will be able to explain the scan path technique for testing the sequential circuits. In previous lectures, we have seen that the combinational circuits can be tested by using either the deterministic test methods or the random test methods. But it is somewhat difficult to test the sequential circuits. The basic reason is, here in case of sequential circuits, presence of the memory elements allows a sequential circuit to be in various states, and the response of the circuit to externally applied inputs depends on the state of the circuit. So therefore, there is a need for checking that the circuit performs correctly all a transition between states, and also it produces a correct output. Okay, so now the problem here is, it is difficult to determine that the circuit is in a specific test because the state variables are not observable on the external pins of the circuit. Therefore, for testing the sequential circuit, there is a need to design the sequential circuit so that they are easily testable. Now, this particular diagram shows the general model for a sequential circuit. Here, the input, external inputs W1 to W2 we have, and the circuit outputs are Z1 to Zm. The state, next state variables, this capital Y1 to Yn in general, and the present state variables Y1 to Yn. So now, these next state variables as well as the present state variables are not externally available. So here, the combinational circuit can be tested very easily by applying these external inputs. It is also possible to observe the outputs, that is Z1 to Zm, because these are externally available. But the problem is to give these present state variables. So one possible solution is to include a two-way multiplexer in the path of each of these present state variable, where in which one of the input will be a present state variable and the other input will be an external input. But the problem here is, the second input of each multiplexer must be directly accessible through external pins, which requires many pins if there are many state variables. So that is not a good solution. So we can think of some alternative attractive approach, wherein which provide a connection that allows shifting the test vector into the circuit one bit at a time. So this alternative method require less pins. So now we'll discuss one such popular method known as the scan path technique. So here, for example, a sequential circuit is shown with three flip-flops. So this is a combinational circuit. We have the input W1 to Wn. We have the output Z1 to Zm. So this combinational circuit and this part consists of three flip-flops. External inputs are W1 to Wn, whereas the outputs are Z1 to Zk. These next state variables are given through the multiplexes. So So these three multiplexes forms a shift register. So the control signal normal bar oblique scan selects the active input to the multiplexer. So in the normal operation, to input to these flip-flops are these state variables as it is, and in case of the scan operation, these multiplexes makes it as a shift register and the external input is shifted into these flip-flops. So during normal operation, the flip-flops inputs are driven by the next state variables y1, y2, y3, and in case for shift testing, the shift register connections is used to scan in the portion of each test vector that involves the present state variables y1, y2, y3. So now the testing method consists of the following steps. So the operation of the flip-flops is tested by scanning into them a pattern of zeros and ones. Say for example 010 11 001 in a consecutive clock cycles and observing whether the same pattern is scanned out. For this normal bar oblique scan is kept to 1 and the input pattern is applied on this scanning. Now the combinational circuit is tested by applying the test vectors W1, W2, dot 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 Wn, as well as these present state variables y1, y2, y3, and by observing the values generated on this z1 to zk and these next state variables y1 to y3. Now, the external inputs W1 to Wn can be applied directly, but for applying these present state variables, the y1, y2, y3 portion of this test vector is scanned into the flip-flops using this normal bar oblique scan equal to 1. And it is run for 3 clock cycles so that this input will be applied to y1, y2, y3. Next, the W1 to Wn portion of the test vector is applied and the normal operation of the sequential circuit is performed for 1 clock cycle. So after performing this, the output generated on Z1 to Zm are observed and generated values of the next state variables y1, y2, y3 are loaded into the flip-flops. So the select input is now changed. This is actually normal bar oblique scan equal to 1, and the contents of the flip-flops are scanned out during next 3 clock cycles, which makes y1, y2, y3 portion of the output observable externally. So this is how, although these present state variables and the next state variables are not externally available, it is possible to apply by making use of this shift register, and it is also possible to observe the next state variable part of output generated by using this. And so this is how this sequential circuit can be tested. Thank you.